Crip Camp, a disability revolution. There is an unapologetic spirit in the title for this documentary from Nicole Newnham and James LeBrecht that immediately grabs you and tells you everything you need to know about this inspiring history of the disability rights movement. And as we learn in the film, Camp Jeanette was, by the 1970s, more than just a summer camp for both kids and teenagers with disabilities. Crucially, it was also a space where the soon-to-be leaders of the disability rights movement, people like Larry Allison, Judith Heumann, and James LeBrecht himself, found the strength and the sense of community they needed to take on a fight that went on to change the very world around us. Crip Camp is both a personal story and an urgent historical record. I first watched this film when I was in the beginnings of adapting to my own disabilities and was and am completely blown away. They came together through the freedom these Crip Camp summers afforded them, and they changed the world, really. Thank you. It's a reminder that activism begins with the personal, for the history it recovers, for the empathetic portrait it paints, for the revolutionary anger and joy it conjures. It is my pleasure to present a Peabody Award to Nicole Newnham and James LeBrecht, the entire Crip Camp team, and Netflix. Congratulations. Thank you.
I remember that my dad used to say to me, you know, Jimmy, you're gonna have to be really outgoing. You're gonna have to go up and introduce yourself to people because they're not gonna come up to you. But at camp, everybody had something going on with their body. It just wasn't a big deal.
What we tried to do was provide the kind of environment where teenagers could be teenagers without all the stereotypes and the labels. We realized the problem did not exist with people with disabilities. The problem existed with people that didn't have disabilities. So it was important for us to change.
We wanted to hear what everybody had to say. We were willing to listen.
I depend on my mother for some things. And so like I can't really fight her as hard as I wish I could.
My parents are great, but sometimes I hate them. Because they're too great and they're too protective of me. And things that I want to do and I would love to do, they say, no, you can't do it, you're handicapped.
I think it's much more out of fear than of a protectiveness.
For me, the camp experience really was empowering because we helped empower each other that the status quo is not what it needed to be.
Thank you to the Peabody Awards and the Peabody jurors. It's a tremendous honor, especially among a group of such powerful transformational nominees. The late disability activist Stacy Park, our impact producer, along with the brilliant Andrea Levant, said that in disability community, ancestors are the people we choose to be connected to and to honor day after day. Crip Camp honors all the disabled ancestors who have fought for justice. At Camp Jeanette, young people chose to be connected to and to honor each other. And over time, they built a movement that reshaped our world. Disability as portrayed by the media all too often falls into two tropes, the tragic or what the disabled comedian and activist Stella Young termed inspiration porn. We're so grateful that you honored this disabled-led, community-told movement story that set out to explode those confines. Thank you to Netflix for being such innovative and creative partners and allies, to our brilliant editors, Eileen Meyer, Mary Lampson, and Andrew Gersh, to Howard Gertler, executive producer extraordinaire, to our story consultant, the most fabulous Denise Jacobson, to Priya Swaminathan and Tonya Davis at Higher Ground, and of course to President Obama and Mrs. Obama for their wisdom, support, and belief in the importance of elevating this overlooked story of civil rights history. It's truly been the honor of a lifetime to work with all of you. And to Jim LeBrecht, you once said as we were embarking on this project, I'm disabled, you're a woman, there's nothing we can't do. You were right. Thank you for trusting me to tell this story with you.
I would like to thank my dear wife and producer, Sarah Boulder, and our daughter, Tess, and my sister, Lindsay. You are the most important women in my life. Nicole, you're number four. Absolutely. Nicole, this has been the adventure of a lifetime, and I'm honored to be your partner on this film. You embrace me in this story with your beautiful heart, talent, and determination. I would not be here without the disability rights activists that have put their lives on the line for all of us. I want to acknowledge the incredible warriors in the disability justice movement that are doing essential work today. To Judy Heumann, and to the counselors and staff and campers that I met at Camp Jeanette. As a 15-year-old, you set a course in my life by showing me what was possible. I want to also give incredible thanks to the People's Video Theater. Those folks captured so many precious moments at Camp Jeanette 50 years ago. Deepest thanks to Andrea, Stacy, Rosemary, and Sophia, who've worked tirelessly for our impact campaign and to really take the power of our film and spread the message and the heart of what we were trying to accomplish. You all have performed miracles. Crip Camp told one story of thousands for my community, my culture. We are one in four in our society, but we're barely 1% of the characters you see on the screen. We have been underrepresented and misrepresented, which perpetuates the stigma and prejudice that we have to fight against every day. Diversity and inclusion initiatives have brought us unique and compelling artists and their films into the world. I encourage everyone to apply the same efforts to the deaf and disabled film people and artists that are ready to work and create magic. Thank you for this award. Nothing about us without us.